Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, new channel, Teardown Operation. Today I'm going to tear down this keyboard. This is a second video and I hope it will be in better quality and so on. So you see all the details of Teardown Operation. I have decided to tear down the second time my keyboard because one of the most important buttons are begin to glitch. It does not work always, and this button is very important for my applications activities. I use it very often when I do shortcuts or hot keys, how they are called. Anyway, it does not matter. This button is very essential for me. Also, this number 2 was glitching, but then it have fixed itself. Not sure why. Maybe the contact was not clean inside. Who knows? So the first step, from what I remember, is better to remove the buttons, the plastic buttons, and we will do this gently. Also, I want to clean it. There is a lot of poop between buttons. As you can see, it goes well. Does not force. Use 2 fingers from sides like that, and it lifts out easy. No force, no bend, nothing. It's like with butterfly. Why not butterfly? I mean, it's like butter goes with oil, like. Do not rush. I hope my video will not exceed. I mean, no, my camera records not more than 27 minutes at such quality. Of course, I have prepared everything, so it does not take me a lot of time. I have prepared my screwdriver and with it bits, with different bits. And I will do it. I hope it will be shorter than the previous video. And I also hope to record the video under my microscope. But I will keep my camera on so it will record my voice, because my microscope camera does not have a microphone. I see that they go easy. Also, you can take a photo of the layout so you know how the buttons were before you take off the buttons. But you can find a lot of them on Google. As you can see, one plastic white have stuck here. But this is not a problem because there is a special metallic part inside which fits. Anyway, this is not very important. Nothing is damaged. You can use both hands. What I also have observed after long usage of this keyboard, I have observed that the black paint and this copper paint is already wearing out, and I don't like this. Sooner or later I will not see which letter is which. will be good that they use it real copper. At thin layer of copper, I don't think we'll waste a lot of copper or will be very expensive. For such a price for this keyboard, I think it deserves real copper. If that button, control, left control button, if it's not repairable, if it's not fixable, I will take some not very useful button and unsolder it and then solder in this place. There are a lot of buttons which I never use. For example, this numerical buttons. I never use them. Only maybe enter button sometimes. As you can see, everything is simple. Now I will do a little bit of aspiration. Okay, let's begin. The second step is to unscrew this metallic frame on the edge of the keyboard. First I use manual force, then I use automatic. Wait, I forgot to put a magnet. The screws on a magnet. To not lose them. Second screw. That when after I made the first video with this screwdriver, and I was explaining that you need to use manual force to unscrew the screws. After this, they made a Chinese made or some company a screwdriver, and there was an add-on to the screwdriver, and I think this is because of my video, because I did not see that before. There are a lot of grabbers outside there, of lazy Chinese grabbers. That's why COVID have came to their country. Because there are a lot of Chinese lazy grabbers. Also in other countries, there are a lot of such lazy people. That steal other people's ideas and present as their own. But I will not discuss this on my video. This grill has some poop around it. I will have to clean it. It's from my hands because I hold like this. Always hold my hand here when playing games also. I will do a little bit of cleaning. Do not add much of cleaning solution. So liquid dough is not fall drop on circuit of the electric board. I see here some poop. I don't know what is this. But I think I will have to unscrew this brand plate. So I will clean it better. As you can see, the black sheet is from the paint of the of this lid here, which was added here. The paint takes off easy. Maybe because this solution of cleaning is having alcohol in it. So maybe you will use other solution for cleaning. Okay, let's lift this frame, metallic frame. I will also wipe a little bit. And put it on the side. Okay. So I am just recording how to tear down the keyboard. I will not record how to assemble it back. Because you only do the reverse order. In the reverse order you assemble it back. Okay, the third step is to unscrew the screws on the back. Replacing the screwdriver bit with the plus one. This is hexagon bit. Those screws here. I will take other magnet for these screws because they are different. I hope there is enough light so you see what I'm doing. Between I did my first and second video this that I do, I did not use it any instructions. And I am sure there was even not available such instructions. Because manufacturers are not interested that the customers repair their devices. And that's why they keep that knowledge hidden from everyone. There are some screws under this hiding. They are a little bit harder to unscrew, but I'm sure I can do that. As I did in the previous video, without removing these parts. Four screws to go. I suspect that these pads can be removed. You only have to unstick these rubber pads, and there is possible the screws which are holding them. I think I use it a small screwdriver for this, which Chinese send you with different LCD screens, so I will try to use it. It went very easy because I did not use last time any force, much force, so it's easy to unscrew them now. So there are total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 screws. I will use a pinchette, a tweezer, I mean, pinchette is in Romanian or Russian, we say pinchette for tweezers. Okay, two screws to go. I have 9 minutes of remaining video, so I will have to record again. This screw doesn't go easy, because the screwdriver has a small handle, it's very hard to unscrew. You need big handle to use more force. That's the secret of screwdriver, of manual screwdriver. One screw more to go. And this is not the end of pain tearing down this keyboard. Okay, now is the hardest step. The fourth step is to lift this plastic. There are some inside there are some plastic. I forgot. Some plastic yards that keep this plastic to the bottom of the keyboard. So you will have to insert something. I even don't remember what they were. I see one here. Let me take my instrument. No, I better take my headlamp, because in this way I will have light to look inside. You can buy such headlight from AliExpress or eBay. It's very useful. I even don't remember where they are. I was looking under the microscope. They were between buttons. Okay, here is one. It's recommended to not bend the cable. Even with headlamp, I don't see where they are exactly. Here is the second. I know that there are some very hard to penetrate. You will need something thinner than this flat instrument. So I'm going from the top. Okay, if it's held here, then it's something. It's somewhere here. And the place between buttons is thin. I need something to push. I think I use it, this dental pick, in this thin places. I have 3 minutes left, so I don't forget to record. I found a broken tweezer which I use for cleaning black resin in knife pointers. On knife pointer logic board. Okay, this is not here. Not here. Not here. Ah, I see him, but I don't know if it's this one. I think it's him. Yes, this was fucking shit. Looking farther. Fucking fuck. See if you don't have someone to help you. It's complicated. Okay, I'm stopping the video and record again. Okay, this is the second video. I first will try to detect where is that plastic. Plastic yarn. Yes, I see one is exactly in this place. And one here I see. In this place. This was it. And one is in this place. This is good progress. Be careful to not force any button because you might damage it.
Fucking shit.
Maybe I should try from this side.
I get the feeling that all of them must go from the top.
I mean to adjust them from the top.
I get the feeling. I think I see him. It's right here. Fuck. Okay, and the others went out. So as you can see, there are total of 1, 2, 3, 4 on the bottom, 1, 2, 3, 4 on the top. So here how they go, where are my fingers? 1 pair, 2 pair, 3 pair, 4 pair. So they go into these holes, rectangular holes. So there are 8 of total of these plastic yards. I hope you see them. Okay, now the 5th step, if I'm not wrong, so this Chinese split tweezer, which is very cheap, can be used to push those yards, plastic yards. Okay, now there are other screws. Which keep this other metallic part, if not, I'm not wrong. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I remember there were missing some screws. And they are missing from factory, not sure why. I didn't screw them in proper place. Because 2 screws were missing. Okay, that's all the screws. Now you lift the holy logic part. But I think this was not needed. Oh my gosh, how I have forgot about this. You don't have to unscrew this if you are not doing soldering jobs. So the buttons are simple to tear down the button. There are on each side of button. On each side of button there are 2 yards, plastic yards, which keeps that cap in place. And to lift it, you just push them in the sides.
So you lift this plastic cup and repair the button. And now I am going to do a video under my microscope. And in the same time I will keep the camera on. Then I will combine both videos, so you will see what I do under microscope. Okay, let's do the tear down of the button of this fault button. My fucking shit of backlight. I can't record a normal video. So I will use my okay. I think to better push 2 yards at one time. I hope I don't do here even worse. Okay. This is the button inside. I am looking and I don't like what I see here. I see dirt here, not sure from what, but it can be from the plastic scratching of too many presses. Okay, now it's better. I hope my backlight will hold. No, it again begins to fuck with me. So here are the contacts. When you press the button, I think the contact is disconnected. Or it can be even vice versa. But you do is not matter. Most important, you must make sure it's clean there.
So for these tiny places between contacts, I use this dental pick
and put a little bit of wool around it. And soak it in alcohol. I hope you will see it in the microscope. Okay, I added alcohol and now I will try to clean. when I took the button off, there was something red. I don't know what it was. And from where it have appeared. So I am going to assemble back the button and test. I can connect two keyboards at the same time. You must put that plastic proper. And you put it back. Okay, I will connect the keyboard and see if it works. Okay, what tasks I will do? I will try CTRL copy and do the CTRL V. Yes, it works. I have copied a lot of files on my desktop. So the button now works. There was some plastic chip, or it was dirty. I don't know. I hope it's fixed. You also can scratch a little bit the contacts with some needle between them. Because if they are made of silver, the silver is known to tarnish. I'm not sure if they are made of silver. So I have decided to record how I will assemble back the keyboard. But I will do some editing to speed it up. So additionally, I have found in my collection of screws the two additional screws, only they are not black color, but silver. And I have seen that I could not screw one screw in one remaining hole. Not sure why. Maybe it's smaller. No, I don't think they are different. But I will try to screw it here. Или Камасута Нагасаки. Yes, this goes easy. But that white screw which I found, I could not screw it in that hole. Okay, here it is. I will try to screw it in this place. And no, it does not screw. Not sure why this screws too went fine.
these are different. I will check if they're... Yes, these are different. It seems that I didn't find similar ones. I did not look more, but I think it's not essential to add all the scripts. It's important in the middle and on the edges. On the edges. So I will assemble it as fast as I can. You just put this plastic back and push in those four places. As you see, it went easy. What the fuck? Okay, from which hole this will, I will put it later when I will insert the buttons. I will add some plastic transparent protection for the keyboard because most of the problems are from dirt and liquid damage and then droplet damage or heat damage. So if you want to, your keyboard to withstand a lot of time, a lot of years, don't hit it hard or at all during gameplay. I know there are such people. I also was hitting my old keyboards, but this one no. Do not hit, do not spill liquids and protect from dirt. That's all, and it will withstand a lot of time. Okay, now the frame, metallic frame, guys. You can put this frame as you want, there is no restriction on which side and how it was or how to put.
Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. I will post other new videos. Have a good day.